anymore.
Hey everybody, this is Fred Ricciani of TSC, your home for gaming reviews, news updates, and everything in between. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. I'm here to give you guys my thoughts on Life is Strange 2, episodes 2 and 3 available on PS4, Microsoft Windows, Xbox One, Linux, and Mac OS. Full disclosure, we received a free copy of this game for the purpose of this review. This is published by Square Enix, developed by Don't Nod Entertainment, who gave us the first Life is Strange series, as well as the hit game Vampire. And in this game, the choices you make affect the outcome of this story, and you play as the DS brothers who were introduced to you in episode 1, who unfortunately had a terrible tragedy occur. Their father died, and in the process, a cop was killed. And this is a game that intertwines brotherly rivalries, some major social issues, including racism and injustice. And these guys are on the run. In episode 1, they had to hide in the forest. They had to find a way to get out, get back on the road, do their thing, have enough money to seek refuge. And when you're a teenager like Sean Diaz, and when you're 9 freaking years old like Daniel, your options are kind of limited. Somehow, some way, they end up in episode 2 at their grandparents' house in Oregon. And after leaving Seattle, making it all the way to Oregon, they stay there with the grandparents, but things are a little bit complicated. They're still on the run. They're still wanted. There is a nationwide manhunt for these kids. And it's kind of crazy because the tragedy of Mr. Diaz results in the death of a cop. And they're accusing these two kids of killing armed police officers. I mean, what kind of evidence do they have here? And here's the thing. If you know anything about the Life is Strange series in general, there is always some supernatural wackiness involved. And in this case, with Life is Strange 2, it is young Daniel who, at the beginning of the series, cannot understand what the hell's going on with him, because anytime he gets angry, high in emotions, and he starts to flare up in his temper, things happen. Objects move. Gravity stands still for a moment and then comes down to a screeching halt. And in episodes 2 and 3, you see Daniel trying to hone his skill, being able to pick up pine cones, being able to pick up logs. Eventually, he gets to the point where, for the most part, he can control it. But unfortunately, he can't always control his emotions, and it leads to Sean and Daniel having to leave in episode 2 from their grandparents' house. And in episode 3, they actually end up with the group of misfits they met earlier in episode 2 in California, where they are currently, engaging in some bud-cutting activities for a marijuana farm and drug business. And in episode 3, we kind of see sort of a coming of age for Sean. I mean, he's starting to like this girl. He may have some interactions with this girl that are of the adult variety. Daniel is coming into his own, for better or worse. We see Daniel's major flaw here, which is not only the fact is that he's a kid, but that he can be majorly influenced by anybody that seems to give him some positive attention, which leads to some not so positive results. I don't want to give too much away here, but I will say this. I know Life is Strange 2 episode 1 was a bit of a hit or miss. I thought overall was a really good story. In the middle, it was kind of boring. It was kind of plotting. It's hard to live up to the hype of the very first Life is Strange series, which I thought was absolutely tremendous with Chloe and Max. It's really hard to do that. I do think that Life is Strange 2 has redeemed itself with episodes 2 and 3, although there are some logic gaps here. How far can these kids really run? Are they really going to get to Mexico on their dad's side and seek refuge? How can they not just explain things? I get that there's the racism aspect of things and dealing with these cops. And, you know, Daniel killed a cop and all this other stuff. But, I mean, I don't know. There's still a few logic holes in this story that will hopefully be answered and hopefully be met ahead in episode 4 and in episode 5. We can expect episode 4, according to Square Enix, August 22nd, and episode 5 all the way on December 3rd. So I hope y'all are patient, and if you haven't had a chance to play these episodes, I'd recommend doing so because I think you'll have a lot of fun, but you may need a hug afterwards. If you enjoyed this review, please like, share, take care, don't forget to subscribe and enable notifications for more updates, and as always, enjoy the games.